We shall overcome. Dear Motherland, I vow to stand by you through thick and thin. My desire is to be loyal, committed, to uphold you with pride. You have given me strength. You have given me hope to carry on. And I do believe as a nation, we will prevail through uncertainty. We shall overcome. In adversity, we will rise. Certainly, this is a phase, a period in time of the unknown. Some feeling so alone, yet this too shall pass. We shall overcome and testify in unity within communities how great our motherland is. But first, we as one nation must abide. Let us educate one another rather than fighting one another. All together we represent one nation, one world. So I plead with you, my people, citizens, do not take risks. Do not take this lightly. Your life matters. Take precautions. Stay safe. Stay home. Save lives. Let us fight this virus together. Look out for one another. Love your neighbor as yourself. And if you can, support the ones in need as a seed. Indeed, you will surely bear fruits for your good deeds. So let us proceed to exceed. Realign your focus. Faith over fear. We shall overcome. Through the storm, through the rain, the sun will surely rise again.
I believe in my African people, my African blood family that is all over this globe. And we have to believe in our purpose, in our mission, the fact that we were all given individual gifts that combined make us unstoppable as a people. We have to continue to rebuild our family unit because it is power within that itself. And to continue to educate ourselves, to continue to share those truths that fortify us and strengthen us to keep our nose to the grindstone and continue to follow the path of our ancestors. We are a special people. We are a blessed people. And we will continue to be. And you will continue to have my support in all of your efforts that you continue to participate in that leads us to the liberation of all Africans. Ashe, ashe, ashe. This is Neo.
Let us hold the light for each other. We may be far apart, but we are all connected in this walk of life. It is absolutely normal to re-examine our focus, goals, and existence during this time. But after this is done, how can we proceed? Let us stand in resilience. Within our heart space, let us love more, criticize less, and practice the art of open-mindedness. Let us lend a helping hand to someone in need. We are beautiful when we stand in our authentic self. But we are even more beautiful if we can stand together. Above all, let us be gentle with ourselves. Let us lift our vibration, because love will always win. Truly blessed, my friends, and remember, we are all on this journey.
This message is for Africans in COVID-19 and the COVID-19 vaccine. You cannot allow these foreigners to trick you again with this pandemic. This is not a pandemic. This COVID-19 is not killing Africans. That is a lie being perpetrated by African leaders to gain money from foreign slave masters. Just think, Africans, we have survived Ebola. We survived HIV/AIDS. We survived SCARS. And here they are again with another pandemic. This COVID-19 has killed way more Asians and European descent people than it has killed Africans. The African leaders are lying about the numbers. They are doing that to collect money from their slave masters in Europe and Asia. Do not fall for these people's trick again. COVID-19 is a virus that spreads in cold climates. It cannot live, it cannot survive in the heat of Africa. For future reference, watch when fall and winter comes back to the Western Hemisphere. Watch the number of COVID-19 cases go through the roof. They will skyrocket. This virus cannot survive in the heat. The reason these numbers are down right now in the Western Hemisphere is because it is summer in this area. Soon as the fall and winter come back, the numbers will go back up. This is a plandemic. This is not a pandemic. This is a trick by people who want to control Africa's natural resources. They know if they put fear in you, people that's afraid would do anything. And they know that they do not want you to be safe. They want your natural resources. They don't want you on Africa. They want to depopulate Africa. That is their plan. That's what Bill Gates is talking about. That's what the Prince and Queen of England is talking about. That's what France is talking about. They are coming for Africa again. Do not allow these people.
Hello, beautiful people. This is Camille from Inner Temple Mission. I am are the two most powerful words that you can say. It speaks directly to your subconscious mind. Say anything long enough and you will begin to believe it. Listen to this as much as possible to form a new mindset. You have the inner strength to overcome everything in these times we are dealing with today. Take a deep breath. Now clear your mind. Go back to your mind. Tap the power within. I am triumphant. I am that I am. I am undefeated. I am victorious. I am strong. I am truly at peace, unbothered by fear. Ashe. I am a master of my mind. My ancestors speaks wisdom unto me. My light shineth in the dark places. I am worthy of greatness. I have greatness inside of me. I am more powerful than I can believe. My faith and hope moves mountains. I am truly at peace, unbothered by fear. Ashe. I am surrounded by love from the universe and others around me. Whatever happens will happen for the greater good. I am part of the greater good. My life has significant meaning. I have a plan for my life. I am moving closer to my purpose and destiny. I am truly at peace, unbothered by fear. Ashe. Fear will be defeated just by doing. Nothing anyone says or does bothers me. I am in touch with myself. I am resilient. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for thy art with me. I am truly at peace, unbothered by fear. Ashe. I sow great seeds. Though I am always present, I plan and prepare for the future. Amidst challenges, I always come out stronger and better because I take every opportunity to learn, teach, and grow. I focus my attention on helping and being of service to my people. I am truly at peace, unbothered by fear. Ashe.
I give tons and tons of gratitude to the universe to be in the present moment. We have passed through so many events. Events that has left many souls broken, lost, deeply wounded, confused, abandoned, and questioning everything that we have been taught. We have been infected and affected in many different ways. Connecting with you right now, oh dear beautiful soul, it is not by accident. I paused to remind myself and to remind you as well that you are awesome, beautiful, amazing, growing, expanding, and advancing in wisdom to overcome the fears from your past events. You are on your way to your best self. I release and let go of all fears. I forgive myself for hurting myself and for hurting others. I forgive myself for blaming and punishing myself for my past mistakes. I forgive my parents for their fears and limitations, for they were only doing what is best at the time. I now declare for myself that I am safe and sound within the universe. I am at home within my body. I am at home within the universe. Mother Earth is my home. Everything that has happened for my highest good. I choose to rise from the ashes of my past and the deepest pain which empowers me to grow into my highest self. I encourage you to reveal your deepest version of yourself that lies within the core of your being, a well of infinite wisdom, a well of infinite knowledge, a well of infinite power, a well of infinite acceptance, a well of infinite forgiveness, a well of infinite peace, a well of infinite power, a well of infinite love, a well of infinite joy. Arise, my dear brother, arise, my dear sister. Arise and conquer. You are on your way to your best self. Out of every brokenness, out of every pain, out of every sorrow, out of every pain, the deepest pain, there is beauty that lies within you. The beauty that lies deeper within you. The beauty of strength, the beauty of resilience, the beauty of perseverance, the beauty of a burning desire, the beauty of a yearning heart to want to overcome every hurdle, every storm, every valley, every tear, every brokenness. Oh yes, oh yes, you are on your way to your best self. You are a conqueror. You are a victor. You are a winner. You are more than enough. You are on your way to your best self. Countless blessings. All is well, and so it is. Love and light to all.
Greetings, my global family. Sanibonani, Dumela, Ikubulisa, Salamu, Etsi, Ago. I bow down to the divinity by transmitting unto you an everlasting life fire of positive energy. This video is going to take your time more than 20 minutes, but it will be your holy gift of knowledge and wisdom for the rest of your life. So listen carefully and you will hear the mystic vibration in your own inner temple. Ashe, Ashe. Our origin is Africa, and Africa lives in us. There is no history without the motherland. I repeat, Africa is the motherland, and there is no color without the supreme black, the foundation of all colors. It is more than 500 years now, and we, our ancestors, have survived the slave holocaust. Most of our African blood brothers and sisters worldwide are still struggling for survival. Historically, some of our prosperous black cities, such as Tulsa, Oklahoma, known as the Black Wall Street, was burned down by the oppressor. And major black African towns flooded and hidden under man-made lakes through the development-induced displacement program by the U.S. government in 1912. And do you even know that Central Park in New York City was predominantly an African town? And we wonder why there are no African towns but Chinatowns in America built by our ancestors. Further to that, syphilis, typhoid, HIV/AIDS, Ebola, SARS, and now COVID-19 with its variant is a biological total war orchestrated on us, the human race, Africans worldwide. Ashe. Take a deep breath, take a deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Instead of allowing Africans to produce their own vaccines, they are donating a patent experimental biotech vaccines to our people, just like our creators, inventors, such as the inventor of our traffic lights of today by Garrett Morgan, an African blood. Automatic elevator by Alexander Miles. Carbon light bulb filament by Lewis Latimer. Fiber optic cable by Dr. Shelley Jackson. Home security system by Mary Van Britten Brown. Pacemaker by Otis Boykin. Blood bank by Charles Drew. Voice over IP, that is, using the internet to make phone call, was invented by Marion Crook, another African blood woman. The world supercomputer by Philip Emil Gwely. The GPUs that we are using in our modern days right now by Gladys West, another African blood woman of the 21st century. And even those precious mirrors in our smartphones, laptops, and electronic gadgets, which are cotton, copper, gold, tellurium, lithium, yes, lithium battery, cobalt, and manganese, are all from Africa. And yet, Africans worldwide are not respected or known for all their contributions towards humanity and the killing of our brothers and sisters at home and in the diaspora continues. Enough is enough of your bullshit and nonsense. Ashe. Take a deep breath. Take a deep breath. Inhale. Exhale. Ashe. The devilish government policies are forcing citizens to inject the BioVec vaccine through restricted systems and traveling measures planned by the capitalist and globalist and group of seven known as the G7. Hence, therefore, Africans worldwide to rise and fight by any means necessary through their do or die life matter movements. Be an action taker and be part of the change we all wanted for ourselves and for our motherland Africa. Ashe. Take a deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Ashe. Being on a spiritual path is never easy. It is treacherous. Your own family, siblings, and friends will turn their back on you. They will even cause you harm with their negative thought projection on your path, or to frighten and traumatize you through the energy of fear. Your marriage and relationship will be disrupted through words of negativity against you. Your goodness will be sabotaged through traitorous activities. But my goddesses and gods, I encourage you to practice detachment off the radar of the social media, of the gossip planet, till you gain inner strength again to battle against evil. Be in your own solitude and let your clairvoyance of your third eye be activated to see and to the unseen, the unknown. This is your personal journey and to your inner temple, and always remember that you came into this universe from your mother's heavenly womb. A woman, where a man planted his seed for germination to be generated by being born to operate. We are in operation of hustling, thriving up and down on this earth planet for a living as a survivor and returning back home, your final destination through the shadow and valley of death, destruction. Hence, your acronym, God, G-O-D. I will exponent the God concept in my future videos for clarity and understanding that you are a God. And that divinity dwells in us all, the inner voice. With my positive mind and my positive heart, I bow down to your divinity within you, with all the powers bestowed upon you and I for a healing of peace, love, and light. Ashe. Take a deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Ashe. Now, I am challenging you, the African blood who is listening right now, to be proud of yourself by staying alive. Do not be defeated by any fear of COVID-19, Third World War. Be fearless. Fight for your health as one people of the sun and of the moon. Blessed and gifted are we with all the organic holistic herbs of the earth. Let ginger, cinnamon, lemongrass, moringa, lime or lemon, turmeric, neem, garlic, fresh coconut water or distilled warm water mixed with the supreme honey from the mighty African bees and a little bit of apple cider vinegar be your medicine, including exercise. Yes, We got to exercise our beautiful melanin body to be in shape. Fasting according to full moon or new moon calendar. Balanced organic raw vegetarian diet and fruits must be your natural medicine for immunization against this third world war COVID virus. Try and be eating at least fruits for your breakfast. Break the fast, just like our honorable Dr. Baba Aries Latham, who at his 70 years of age is still able to climb coconut trees for his regular daily natural juice. Check him out on YouTube and support our elders with their good work, as selfless service to humanity is service to God. Ashe. Take a deep breath, take a deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Ashe. Listen to what your body needs. Eat and drink when your body needs it. And treat your body like a temple, like a church. Be in a vibrational frequency by connecting with nature, the forest, the mountains, rivers, and the ocean for a healing. Fear is not the answer at this time of biological war against humanity. Your life is of a significance in this universe of ours, and because of you, I am that I am, God. I repeat, because of you, I am that I am, God. Ubuntu. Fear not, for the spirit and blood of our African elders and warriors, Fela Kuti, Thomas Sankara, Chris Honey, Patrice Lumumba, Prophet Bob Marley, Steve Biko, Nana Santewa, Malcolm X, Nzinga, and other ancestors who fought fearlessly for our freedom lives in you. Do you understand that? Do you understand that? The spirit and energy of our warriors and our ancestors lives in you, you, the African blood. Be proud of that and stop being afraid of the oppressor. Stop being afraid of the oppressor. Ashe. Take a deep breath. Inhale. And exhale. Ashe. Leverage COVID-19 to your advantage, as you can work from home by creating your own multiple streams of income beside your regular job. That's the power of economic freedom against fear of the unknown in the diaspora or even in the continent of Africa. The choice is always yours of how you create your life by your thoughts. Our human world is created from the human mind planet, the creative intelligence of the inner voice or inner temple within us all. Ashe, 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 take a deep breath, take a deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Ashe. Now, do this with me. Chest out. Take a deep breath. Concentrate. Focus. Breathe in and breathe out. For the best practice regarding this technique I am about to share with you must be performed directly under the sun. If not, anywhere else is fine. You must create your own way of communicating with the God within you, your superconscious mind, your inner temple, your inner voice, and get ready. Ashe, 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 ashe. Take a deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Ashe. Now pay attention and listen carefully to instruction for self-healing. You may lie down flat on your back, on your spinal cord, or in your own comfortable position. Chest out and take a deep breath in and out 3 times. Take a deep breath. Let's do it. 1, 2, and 3. Focus, concentrate, close your eyes, activate your energy centers of your body, and be in touch with yourself by massaging your parts, every part of your body from head to toe. Be powerful as a warrior. Imagine and visualize a pure light from the sun, Ra, the sun god. The life force energy entering your body, starting from your left and right toes, flowing in harmony through your spinal cord while breathing deeply in and out. Let that pure sunlight of vital energy flow to your pineal gland. At this time, this moment, this second and month of the year, you must hypnotize yourself and see yourself healed till the pure light touches your third eye of awakening. And then let that pure sunlight flows over your head as the seventh chakra, the crown, in a circular motion, and repeat with me. Are you ready? Repeat with me. I am my own master healer, the controller of my mind planet, my body, my soul, my emotions, my destiny. And I choose to heal myself from negative thoughts to the positives, from imperfection to perfection, from dark to light of permanent happiness. I am healed. I am fearless. I am my own healer by my own faith and by my own belief system, by my own inner voice. I take full ownership of my life, my karma of good and bad actions and reactions. My journey, my life, lessons are my responsibility and accountability. I stand up and fight fearlessly for my health by any means necessary. I will study myself like a textbook to gain self-knowledge against fear, and I will worship the God within me. I am that I am God from birth in this life to my departure from this universe. Fear and procrastination will not be part and parcel of my life. I repeat, fear and procrastination will not be part and parcel of my life. Ashe. Take a deep breath, take a deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Ashe. Another simple remedy which is helping those with chest congestion is purple onion. Crush it and wrap it in a clean facial towel or handkerchief. Once that is done, then sellotape it onto your chest before bedtime. You may also try another home remedy, that is making your own herbal medicine tea for nerve calmness before bedtime. That is ganja tea, marijuana, ganja tea, the gold green. The gold green. For those in Africa or in the tropics who have access to fresh herbs and plants, mix a little bit of fresh organic ganja marijuana leaf, lemongrass leaf, moringa leaf, and neem leaf with lemon juice in warm water and a pinch of salt. And of course, honey. Don't forget honey. Honey bees, the wisdom, the honeys, the honey. Drink at least a glass of that tea before bedtime, and you will see some relief. And by the next day, and continue doing so at least for 7 days, and be consistent with anything that you do in life. For those who want to detox the body and lose weight, may continue with the same recipe, but this time you need to do fasting according to full moon or new moon calendar, either dry or wet fasting, which we do publish in our private Facebook group known as Africans Worldwide. again, our private Facebook group known as African Worldwide. We do publish mostly monthly our fasting calendar. Check us out and make sure you are in the right group, because some people are using our brand name, Africans Worldwide. So make sure the group that you are in, which is Africans Worldwide, is private. Our group is private. It's not for the public. It's for the chosen. Or check out our link below. I'll put the link below. But please, let me know and share your positive or negative results in the comment below regarding whatever you have learned from this video. We are here to help each other. I repeat, we are here to help each other. And truth be told. Let the truth be told. From the truth and light, you are free. Always remember, what matters the most in this universe is our health. Again, our health, our survival, and our self-knowledge of continuous learning. I repeat, you must continue learning, relearning, and unlearning. I said three things about knowledge. Continuous learning, one. Relearning, two. And unlearning, using your critical reasoning, your critical thinking. Be the gateway to your inner temple of self-realization, of know thyself. Relate to your seventh chakra of your superconscious powers of ideas, creativity, inner strength, and critical reasoning. Be the truth and light. Let honesty be your best policy. Ashe. And don't forget to share and subscribe. Don't keep this knowledge to yourself. Share it. Share it to humanity. Share it to Africans worldwide. And subscribe to our YouTube channel, The Inner Temple Mission. When talking is done, we have to do more work of walking and working as United Africans Worldwide. We got to build together and work together as a team by building our own heaven on earth in Africa. We have work to do in Africa. I have the land. We have the land, Africans Worldwide, in the sustainable projects in Ghana, West Africa, and in South Africa. We have been talking more than four or five hundred years by blaming others for our misfortunes based on superstitious beliefs and religion, dogmatic religion. Organized spirituality does not take us anywhere. Till now, we are nowhere on this human platform. We must do more as gods and goddesses. We must work as a united team in Africa for the green gold with vast opportunities in the 54 countries of the motherland, the continent of Africa, heaven on earth. The future is how you make it in life. And Africa is calling. Our ancestors are calling. They are calling. Listen to your inner voice and make the move to the motherland as united soldiers to beat your home in Africa. Yes, it can be done. But you gotta change your mindset. You have to change your mindset through inner engineering. And be prepared as a soldier. Mind change through inner engineering. Thank you and all my global family for watching and listening, and keep on riding with me. One love, one human race, and one African blood worldwide. Ashe, ashe, ashe. Point.
I'm not your man.